Assalamu alaikum. Hope you all are well and are safe at your home. Today we are going to discuss the poem Stopping by the Woods on a Snowy Evening. This is the poem in your book, and it is on page number 11 of the book, and it is also the first poem of your course that we are going to discuss. First, let us discuss about the poem. Poet of the poem. This poem is written by Robert Lee Frost. He was born in 1874 and he died in 1963. He was born in San Francisco. He was a poet, a teacher, and also a farmer. He won 2 Pulitzer Prizes for his poetry. He was born in the city of San Francisco. He was a poet. He usually wrote poem about the beauty of the nature or about children's. He usually wrote poems about children's, regarding children's and their antics and their habits and children's nature. He was also a teacher, and apart from that, he was also a farmer. He had won 2 Pulitzer Prizes, as I mentioned before. Pulitzer Prizes are those achievement awards which you get when you done when you have done a remarkable work in any magazine, in any newspaper, or in any online journalism that you can do. Remarkable work, like with the work which had been appreciated by everyone on that platform and any other different platform. Now let us read the poem and discuss the poem. Whose woods these are, I think I know. His house is in the large village though. He will not see me stopping here to watch his woods fill up with snow. He was traveling from an area and he stopped by a corner of the woods, and then he was so mesmerized by the wood that he stopped there and looked at the woods. He was thinking to himself that he knew the owner of the woods, and the owner's house was in the village. And if the poet stopped near the woods, the owner wouldn't notice and wouldn't mind if he stopped there to watch the wood fill up with the snow that was falling at that time. My little horse must think it queer to stop without her farmhouse near, between the woods and a frozen lake, the darkest evening of the year. He was thinking to himself that his horse would be thinking it's strange to stop there at that time of the year, because there was no rest house nearby, there was no farmhouse nearby, or any restaurant or any hotel where they could stay. So he might be thinking it's strange because there was nothing there to stay, and there was a frozen lake nearby, and it was between the woods and the frozen lake, like there was no place to stay, and it was almost dark time, and it is also the darkest night of the darkest evening of the year, because the snow was falling so hard. And the poet is thinking that his horse would be thinking it strange to stop by at that time by the woods. He gives his harness bells a shake to ask there if there is some mistake. The only other sounds the sweep of easy wind and downy flake. Harness bells are the bells which is used to control a horse, and they are tied in the horse's necks, which is used to control him if someone is riding on it. So just to ask the rider, the poet, that if there is a mistake in stopping there, or if there's by mistake he had stopped there, so he just wanted to ask the rider. So he couldn't speak, so he shaked his harness, he shaked his hat, and by shaking his hat, his harness bell rang, just to ask the rider if they had stopped there by mistake, because there was no one else around and there was no sound or anything, just the sounds of blowing wind and snow falling. The woods are lovely, dark and deep, but I have promises to keep and miles to go before I sleep. boy thought that this is that was a very beautiful sight. He was watching the whole forest fill up with the falling snow, but he had promises to keep. He can't stay there longer because he has to move faster and he has to reach his destination before going to sleep. And miles to go, right? And miles to go before his step, he has to reach his destination at that time. So he couldn't stay there for very long time. So he just stood there for some minutes to watch the beautiful forest fill up with the beautiful snow. And then after some time enjoying himself, he left the place.